In this video, I will explain basics of user administration in SAP system. To work with SAP systems, you have to learn different types of user accounts are involved in at each level. That is, there are three levels involved in SAP systems. They are at operating system level, at database level, and at SAP level. Okay, to access SAP system, you will generally use SAP logon program, and this particular program will be installed in the front end computer from where you want to log on to the SAP system. So for suppose if you want to access SAP system from your laptop and the SAP application server installed in another server and the database server is installed in another server. That means three layers are separated, and each application, that is application, database and SAP logon program, is installed in different systems. And first of all, let us talk about SAP logon program. To log on to SAP system, you have to use this SAP logon icon. You have to double click on it here. Okay, to get this particular SAP logon, you need to enter into the operating system using operating system user account. That means at front end, you will see two different types of users. They are OS users and SAP users. So it is already desktop is showing, means I have already used to log on to the OS level. At front end, that is front end computer, you need to have two types of user accounts to work with. And for suppose if you want to work with its application server only, that means if you want to start the application server, you need to have only operating system user accounts. That is, from directly from here you can double click on SAP management console to start the application server. So like this, after expanding it, you can start the application server by right clicking here and click on start, so that the application server will be started. To start this, what all the user accounts are needed? Only the OS users. There is no need to have the SAP application server user. Okay, once it is started, you can access the SAP system using SAP logon program from the front end computer. And the database level user, for suppose the database is installed in separate server, you need to have two types of user accounts there. Again, those are operating system users and database users. Okay, as we have installed everything in the single server, that's why everything is visible here. In the real time, you can separate these particular systems into different layers. Okay, so now let us look at logging into SAP system. Just double click on SAP logon to log on to the system. Double click on dev. Using the SAP level user account, I am logging in. Okay, so once you have the user name and password, you can use those two combination, that is username and password combination, to log on to SAP system. Once you are inside SAP system, you can execute different types of T codes based on your authorizations. So there are different authorizations available to run each and every function within the SAP system. Okay, for suppose if you want to run some T code, like SM50 is a T code. So when you enter using your keyboard, it will do authorization check in background. If you have the authorization to perform that particular action, it will show you the initial screen of that particular function. If you do not have the authorization, it will give you the error message in the status bar saying that you do not have authorization to run this particular T code. So let us see what will happen using enter. Like, I am hitting enter from my keyboard so that it should display the initial screen. As it is displayed, that means this particular user has the authorization to run this particular T code. Okay, now if you do not have the authorization to run this particular T code, what will happen? Let us see. So to see that particular information, that is that particular message saying that you do not have authorization, First of all, you need to have some user account within the SAP system without assigning any authorizations to it. Okay, let us do that. First of all, let me create user account very fastly using SU01T code. And there is a separate video for explaining how to create user account, so that don't worry about creating user account in this video. Just for testing purpose, I am quickly creating an user account called demo1. I am not assigning any authorizations. Without assigning authorization, just created user account and again trying to log on to the system using newly created user account. Let us see what type of message you will see in the status bar. Just see, you are not authorized to use transaction SM50. That means this particular T code, this particular user doesn't have the authorization to run this particular T code. So each and every T code is having some set of authorization objects in background. Okay, without those authorization objects, you cannot perform any action. So that is the concept of authorizations involved in the user maintenance. Okay, so let us log off and log in back again using fully authorized user. So this is the initial screen. Let us execute some other T code like this, and it is allowing me. And once you get this screen, okay, once you enter something here and if you try to execute something, like if you click on the button which is available in the application toolbar, and some other authorizations may check, that means each and every T code may have more than one authorization objects involved. And these are all the authorization objects combined together and created as roles. Roles will be attached to the user account so that particular user can perform those functions, whatever the authorization objects are added in the form of roles. Okay. And that is actually the concept of the user administration as well as the authorization concept. I hope you understood very well. And one more thing is that, and each time we are executing some function means each time it is contacting its underlying database, and all the work processes are available here will use common user account to connect to the database level. So these are all the work processes will use common user account at database level to fetch the data from the database. Okay, that's all about basics of administration, user administration. I hope you understood. Thank you very much.